Hey guys, sorry, I didn't realize it was 9 o'clock already. Oh, hey Brittany, I thought you were coming into class. I'll take you off. Okay, so give us about 5 minutes, okay? Sorry, I lost track of time a little bit. All right.
I'm sorry.
Okay, can you guys hear me? Can you hear me when I'm over there? If at any time it's like glitching like it was last night or you can't hear me, chat and it will pop up and I'll know and I'll come back over around this area, okay? Good. All right, so easy seated position is where we're gonna start.
So just sit nice and tall. Try not to arch the back, though, right? You don't wanna stick our chest and our booty out. Let's engage the core, so knit the ribs in and try to sit the tailbone or the sit bones onto the mat. And then your shoulders are relaxed, your chin's parallel to the mat. Close the eyes. And just check in. So no manipulation of the breath yet. No movement, just witnessing, checking in, noticing where you are. So I like to bring in the koshas, which are the five layers or sheets of ourself. And the outermost layer, they act like Russian dolls. So the biggest doll is the physical body. It's the layer we're most connected with. The bones, the muscles, the skeleton body, the tissues. So just notice where you're carrying any tension, any tightness, any stress. Try not to judge it. We're just reporting. We're just checking in. And then let's go in a little bit deeper. So as we go in the layers, they become more subtle. So the next layer is the energy body. Sometimes, you know, we get out of bed with a big pep in our step, ready to go. Sometimes it's really hard to get here. Especially home practicing. You know, oftentimes we might show up on our mat, but we're mentally someplace else. So just check in where you are. Again, no judgment, just witnessing, just noticing. And then one more layer in. I say this is kind of where our yoga begins. It's the mind. Where is the mind dwelling? What are the thoughts doing? Usually directly related with energy. Sometimes they're all over the place. Sometimes they're really slow, foggy. And now let's come into the breath. I kind of say the breath is like the string that sews those three layers together. And I'll get into the other layers as we get into the practice. But these are the three layers that we first start connecting. So begin to breathe in and out of the nose, preferably. That's unavailable, then obviously use the mouth. But long, deep breaths. So deeper breaths than you normally take on an automatic response. So manipulating the breath. So ujjayi breath has a slight constriction in the back of the throat. And now let's send the breath to the areas that we've identified as tense and tight and start to move this energy. We do it with awareness, we do it with breath, prana, chi, energy. So exhaling all the air out. Take an inhale for a count of 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Again, inhale for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Again, inhale 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Continue on. Inhale. And exhale. So start to slow the fluctuations of the mind by focusing on the breath. Again, inhale. And exhale.
Round the spine, pause here. Curl the toes, hover the knees, two breaths. Draw arms, inside creases of the elbows, spiral them forward. One more breath, retraction of the shoulder blades. On your exhale, downward facing dog. First dog of the day for all of us, even you, Elizabeth, I'm sure you're on here. She's got like 120 classes. Mom's consumption is amazing. Walk your dog. I swear, she really is. Come up high on the toes. Drop the heels over to the right. Again, high on the toes. Bend the knees. Yeah. And then straighten the legs, hips come up high again. Drop the heels over to the other side. Inhale back through center. Downward facing dog. Ripple forward, high plank pose. Let's get right into it. Shoulders again, stacked on the wrist. Same as the tabletop. Inside creases of the elbows, spiral forward like you're opening a jaw. From traction between separation of the shoulder blades, wrapping through the upper body. Squeeze the inner thighs together. Press through the heels. One more breath. Inhale. Downward facing dog as you exhale. Inhale, ripple forward, high plank pose. Pause it here, stay strong in the upper body, strong in the legs, knit the ribs in. One more breath. Downward facing dog. All right, one more, this time we're gonna move forward. Inhale again, ripple forward, high plank pose, but pause. Inhale, get strong in the upper body, and as you exhale, lower down, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Nice, inhale, cobra, warrior up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Exhale it out. Take the right leg up. Yawn it open. Bend the legs. Stack the hips. Check your opposite heel. Press through that left heel. Lift the right knee up. Opposition. Circle it out. Reverse. Yeah. Inhale, straighten your legs. Square it up. Exhale, bring it in. Keep the nose round. Like spine. Nice. Inhale high. Exhale all the way through. Dragon pose. Foot comes to the outer edge of that hand. You choose your intensity. Back knee can be down. Can be up. Can be on the hands, the elbows. We fly. That right arm up. Behind. Return call. Two more breaths.
Reverse.
took on the other side, taking here about 3 breaths. Thank you. So when the pose gets intense, our breath starts to intensify, right? One more breath. Exhale, pull forward. Inhale, flat back halfway. Set the left foot back, right to go lunge. Release the back knee. Inhale, the arms come up. As you exhale, practice the arms out to the side. Press through your back knee first. Put it down and then lift up and reach back. Extend over that front leg, reach the arms forward. And bring the hands all the way down from that. Lift the back knee. Left hand stays right hand. Squeeze those inner thighs together. Nice, perfect. Press to the big toe of the front foot. Yeah, there we go. And the hand that's in the air, bring it down to the outside of that foot. Take the hand that's on the mat up, left arm comes up. So it's a side body stretch in the left, a little funky. Yeah, perfect. And then both hands come down, root to rise, press and lunge. All right, neutralize the pelvic floor here. Tailbone down, hip points up. Draw the ribs in, soften the shoulders. Good. Perfect. Breathe, 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 guys. One more breath. Exhale, heart center. Take a twist. Left elbow moves on that right knee. So it helps to shift the body forward or come high on the back toe. Pressing the hands back through almost heart center as you twist a little deeper. Good. Inhale, the arms come back overhead. Extend over that front leg. Energy through the back heel. So equally pressing through the back heel as you're reaching forward. It's called opposition. We're gonna go right into some balance. Shift forward, warrior three. So you got your L-shaped handstand here. You bring the arms out in front, the palms facing the front. Dial down that hip that's in the air. Yeah, there you go. Flex the foot that's in the air. Great, press through the big toe of your standing foot. One more breath, deep inhale. Exhale, press and lunge, tap the back foot down. Inhale, lengthen. As you exhale, open warrior two. So front toes, follow the bottom knees, back. Root through the back heel equally though. Again, the opposition. Reverse warrior, back hand, back leg. Straighten the front leg, reach back, back, back. And then bend the front leg to a side angle. Forearm hooks to the thigh. There's three breaths here, so maybe you find no birds of paradise yet. So pull the shoulders back as you press the hips forward. Good. One more breath. If you have the bind, go ahead and release it, but pause. Deep inhale. Exhale. Next inhale, reverse the warrior back in and back leg. Straighten out front leg, hinge back, go back, go back. And then triangle pose, hinge forward. And let the hands fall anywhere that it lands, not forcing it. Pull the shoulders back as you press the hips forward. Neutral the spine. Draw the ribs in, draw the knee. Good. One more breath. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, settle on your edge. Good. Inhale, lengthen through the spine. As you exhale, windmill your arms down. High plank pose. Mind, focus on the breath. We focus on the breath, practicing yoga. We're slowing all the other things, all the other distractions, and concentrating on what is. One more breath. Left hand comes into the center for side. Lift back. Drop the bottom knee is always an option. Lifting the top leg is always an option. Squeeze the legs together. Good. Hand into the air, bring it forward. Let the palm face down to soften that shoulder. Maybe take the gaze up. And one more breath, inhale, lift, 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 and then exhale to low plank. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Three breaths or take dolphin pose. naturally go to the heels. We want balance, a little bit more forward, equal weight in the toes and the heels. Draw the belly in, relax your head, no wrinkles in the back. Bow, bow, one more breath. Exhale, release the hands. Walk it back out, downward facing dog. Inhale, look between the hands. As you exhale, step up or flip, feet flat up or hopping. Fold forward. Inhale, flat back halfway. Exhale, fold, chair pose, sit down, Utkatasana. So again, weight to the heels, you should be able to wiggle the toes a little bit. Neutralize the pelvic area, tailbone down, the points up, shoulder soft, smile on the face and the jaw, let's relax. Two more breaths. One more breath. As you exhale, stand tall. As you inhale, chair pose. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, flat back halfway. This time, step the right foot back, left foot up, release the back knee. Inhale, the arms come up overhead. Palms here. So square off the hips. We tend to kind of open this back hip. Pull the front hip back a little bit. Root through the back knee and then cactus the arms out to the side. As you press down with the knee, lift up with the chest and take it back. One more inhale. And then as you exhale, extend, reach forward over the front leg. Good. More breath. Bring the hands down to the mat. Curl the back toes, lift the back knee. Right hand stays, left hand lifts, revolve your crescent. Squeeze the inner thighs together. Notice if that left hip pops open. Press through the big toe of your front foot. Perfect. Hands to the air. Bring it down outside of that foot. Right hand, bring it up. And then both hands come down to the mat. Train that foot. When you're ready, move to rise. Press a lunge. Good. Nice. Squaring off the hips. Nice. Deep inhale, lengthen. As you exhale, draw it from your center and twist. Right elbow comes on that left knee. It helps again to shift forward, coming high on the back toes. Press the palms together and try to work them back towards your heart. Good. Inhale, the arms come back overhead. As you exhale, extend forward. Don't fly yet, just stay here. So shoot energy through your back heel. And let energy shoot through your fingers. Like you're reaching into this wonderful 2020 energy. Shift forward, warrior three. Good, fabulous here so far. It's fabulous. Dial down that hip. Good. Legs hook one that's in the air. Press through the big toe. To the standing foot. One more breath. Breathe, 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 guys. As you exhale, press and lunge. Again, inhale, lengthen. Now as you exhale, open the warrior two. Front knee is stacked on the ankle in line with the knee. So you should be able to see the big toes. Arms are strong, shoulders are soft, draw the ribs in. Nice, guys. Reverse the warrior. Back hands back in. Stay. Deep inhale. Exhale, stay. And then inhale, straighten that front leg. Keep pinching that. And as you exhale, move into your side ankle. Now it's three reps. So if you bound on the other side, right. Press the knee out as the hips go forward. Root through the back heel. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Two more. Fire. One more. So release the mind, but stay. Keep it now. Back down. And then reverse the warrior. Inhale. Straighten that front leg, reach back. Try your pose and hold. Let the hand fall wherever it does, not forcing it to the ground. So we tend to kind of get here. We want to stack that torso on that front leg. So draw the ribs in. And then to the air, your shoulders are stacked. Sweep that back heel and toes. Nice. One more breath. Inhale, hold your three. Exhale, settle. Inhale, length. As you exhale, we feel the arms down the mat. Take a flow, high to low, and then press back up high plank. Three breaths. Again, all of this is suggested. You do not have to take it. You can skip plank. You can go right to down low. Right hand comes into the center, side plank. Step stack shoulders, stack hips, but squeeze the legs together. Your legs are so important in this moment. Lift the hips up, draw the ribs in, hands in the air, bring it forward. One more breath, inhale, lift. As you exhale, low plank. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog, again, three breaths. Dolphin pose is available for child's pose.
Right.
equal. If you're leaning forward, no. You want to be able to balance on that leg. So walk back a little more. Have some trust, some faith in yourself. You want to kick up. You want to grab the ankle. 2 more breaths. Work the pose for whatever it is you need. 1 more breath. Half moon, Archadasana. Left hand's going to stay. You're going to stack and open the hips and the shoulders. Now, if you feel like you're falling behind, the foot is probably too far back. Get it in line with the butt. Cock it forward a little bit. If you want to bind. You have 2 more breaths. Wherever you are, lean here. Don't go someplace else to avoid what's happening. Lean right here. It's a great practice, a great training. Releasing the mind, moving through warrior 3. If you fall, pick yourself back up. Slight up dog chest, draw the ribs. Alright, we're gonna pinch them that leg without touching. Just bring your leg out, standing stack. If that's too much, bend. Okay? Try not to lean back like I am. The duck, trap. And then right hand, grab the big toe or grab the knee, extend it again to big toe, bring it out to the side. Good. Try to keep that hip stacked on the ankle. Tend the knee to the left heel. Lift up, go up. 1 more breath. Come back to center. Switch the hands so the left hand grabs the leg or knee. Back to center, release the leg, keep it out for 5, 4, 3, 2, tree pose. There's an arm balance here if you want it. If not, why are your hands again? We're learning to bend. We're learning to flow. So we don't break. 3, 2, 1. Stand tall, Tadasana. Just close the eyes. Try not to fidget. Try not to move. Just be here. Feel your heart. Feel the energy. Feel the breath. Back to that same pose. No intention. 1 more breath. All right. Foot of the eyes open. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Set up for Crow Bakasana. Separate the feet so they're hip distance. Hands are shoulder distance. Everybody can try this, especially you at home. Get ready. Just try it. Grab your dog to use as something to go under your head if you need. Hug the elbows, shift forward, and just start to shift the weight into the hands. The feet never have to lift off if you're not ready for it. If you want, maybe just lift 1 foot at a time. Try. See where the strength is. See where the balance and the focus is. 2 more breaths. Breathe. Don't hold the breath. 1 more. Get out of there. Step, hop, float, crawl, high to low, lean it down, dog. Take 3 breaths. You need child pose to get. Inhale, high. Left knee left try. Shift forward. Hold or fly for 3. two, three, one. Inhale, ah. Exhale again, knee to nose. Inhale, ah. Left knee, opposite tricep, hold it, fly it for three. Try to tap that elbow just for a second, for two. Nice, small and triangle. It comes out, right arm comes up. One more breath. Right on into side plank, right hand into the center, roll it up, other side, stack shoulders, stack hips. Maybe lift that leg this time. Nice, one more breath. High plank pose, last push and plank, five breaths. Close the eyes, ignite that internal fire. Right, if it gets to be too much, drop the knees. Don't lose the integrity of the upper body. The neck stays in line with the spine. Three more breaths. Protraction of the shoulder blades, separate them like you're a cat. Great. Good. One more breath. Shift forward, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog, pause. Nice. And then exhale, down for crazy. We're almost there, guys. Inhale the left leg up. Walk the hands back, standing split, standing needle back to the mat. Remember, walk it all the way back so that hip is directly in line with the ankle. Balance. Grab the ankle or kick up. Three. Two. Breathing, breathing, breathing. Most important part of the practice. One more breath. Place back in Ardha Dasana. I have to move right hand to the earth. Block, cat, dog, child, whatever you're using. Flex the foot that's in the air. Make sure it's activated. Your legs are an equal part of every pose. If you feel like the foot's falling behind, cock it forward, take a bind if you'd like for two. One more breath. Release the bind, coming through warrior three. It's a hard transition, so if you fall, just pick yourself back up, give your leg a little bit of love. Light up the chest here, draw the ribs in, one more breath. Standing stack, pendulum that leg forward. Remember, you can always bend the leg. Try not to lean back, try to lean up. I like to even bring my arms up. Hold it here for one more breath. And then take that left hand, either grab the knee or hook the big toe. Extend it out first. It's okay if it's bent. You're working towards something, then bring it out to the side. Our arms aren't as long as our legs. Okay. One more breath, lengthen nice and tall. And then come back through the center and switch grips. So the right hand grabs the foot or the outside of the knee. And you just start to twist. Lengthen tall, twist through the center. Beautiful. One more breath. Back through center, release the foot, hold it, standing stack for five. For four. Three, two, one, tree pose. Again, fly your branches. Do something different than what you always do. We need some dichotomy. We need to break up our monotony. Groundhog Day again and again and again. Two more breaths. One more breath. Exhale, stand tall, close the eyes to that. Just on that third eye, stay here, stay resting. One more time. Link the eyes open, inhale the arms up. Exhale, fold forward, heel toes and feet out for yogi squat. In pose number one. And again, if you need a prop, grab whatever you've been using for the last 2 months. Sit back, tend to go forward, and it's okay if we're still somewhat forward. Just know initially we want the heels down. So we want to press through the pinky side blades to the feet. So we want to sit up nice and tall, draw the ribs in. And then once you're there, you're there. focus. I can do this. I am here.
You're all with us, son. You're all
so there's four components, maybe five, depending on the lineage you're in. The first one is to find how deep you go. The second one is to be still. Commit yourself in that position without fidgeting, without moving, without trying to avoid the sensation of what's happening. The third is a minute and a half of water. Each of you should take care of that. And the fourth is the repose, transitioning out. So 10 more breaths to do this.
Yeah, 60 days from May 7th. So hopefully that changes, but neither here nor there. We are going to do another workshop.
equally done virtually, so if you're interested in the other end of the song, go ahead and straighten that leg and fold over it. And it's called Shaman Journey. She's a Peruvian shaman. It's pretty amazing. So half monkey, fold over, work the hamstrings. Just do about five more breaths here. But if you're there, that's okay. Breathe and try to find some relaxing into it. If you already can relax into it, don't check out. Hold that focus. That's the practice of yoga. It doesn't matter what physical position the body's in. It doesn't matter if you're brushing your teeth, driving a car, or in pigeon pose. Yoga is a practice of the mind. It's slowing the fluctuation of the mind. It's slowing all the noise and the assumptions and the reflections that go on a daily basis over and over and over. Especially when we're in a space of unknown. Which our current life situation off the mat is very unknown right now. We've all been through a whole range of emotions. In your yoga class, it's pose after pose, not knowing how long you're going to be there, what's coming next, being led, being guided. So our teacher, Brian Pess, talks about the great let go. I think our society tries to avoid that topic, but we're all going to go up. If you think about it, our entire journey on this planet is building up until that moment. The Buddhists believe the most important moment in your life is the moment before death.
So
wherever your mind is at that moment is where you come back, the reincarnation itself. Learn to let go of the little things. My mom taught me a lesson at a very young age. Pick your battles. Of course, I didn't learn it. I'm still learning it now, but like everything's my battle. Everything's my play. Balance, right? That's Buddha's teaching, moderation. It's the key to everything. Another thing the shaman taught me. You know, I said, I don't even know if the emotions I feel are real. I just know I'm supposed to feel that way. And that's our indoctrination. That's our programming. She said, when you're feeling something, stop. Breathe. Same thing I teach you guys. Breathe. You don't know what to do. Breathe. One thing to teach it, another thing to do it. Right? Quiet. I find myself breathing a lot. Deep breaths. Trying to acknowledge and identify what it is I'm even feeling. Because my go-to emotion is anger. Anger is not an emotion. Superficial emotions to prevent you from feeling the real emotions. Anger is the complete opposite of love. Anger is usually attached to fear. Five more breaths.
One more breath. Stay with it. Exhale. Half split. Straighten the front leg as you fold over. So now we're focusing on that front leg. Or the hamstrings. It doesn't matter again what it looks like. As long as you're feeling it, you're in it. Congrats. In our head are those people. They're there we somehow along this journey take on as ours. So a huge part of peeling back the layers is discerning from all of that noise, I like to call it shit, and honing in on our own truth. And the most inner layer is that peaceful state that we all are, that pure samadhi, nirvana, heaven, light, pure potentiality, that blank canvas, our soul's desire, that inner child before we retain. The more we experience that self, our higher self, the more we start to walk in our own truth. And almost always, our own truth aligns with universal laws, universal truths of love, of light, of passion, of connection. We are all one. We are all so similar. Experience the same emotions, we just manifest it differently. The more you can tap into how you feel and what you've experienced on your journey, the more you can understand others. The more you can put yourself in their shoes and have compassion versus defensiveness, understanding versus arguing, allowing versus resisting. It's a practice. You don't get it one day and it's just there. It'd be awesome. It's not like that. Brian has another thing he says, whatever you feed, whatever you pay attention to in life, it grows and manifests. Whatever you don't, it dies. What thoughts are you nurturing right now? What thoughts are you feeding? What habitual way of thinking are you feeding? Is it honoring you? Is it honoring those closest to you? It's not free will, sort of right now, but free will, freedom of choice. Choose to do it differently. Find more practice. Actually, no, I'm not. I don't mind the touching, you guys. I don't like the laundry. That's true. New somewhere I do. Every day. At least 5 minutes of Shavasana. You hear me? I'm holding you accountable. It's important, guys. This is the practice. Even if your mind is all over the place for 5 minutes, you still attempted it. You're still going to reap the benefits of it. 108. Oh, that's a magical number, Elizabeth. 108 since March 1st. You're already crazy. All right. So no music for Shavasana. If you're planning to play this at home, go ahead and stop it. Get as comfortable as you can. So this is corpse pose. Ironically, the great let go. Right? So let it go. Let your day go. Let the noise of your responsibilities or the stress of life just go for 5 minutes. That's all. Take a deep breath in. the mouth, sigh it out. Again, deep breath in. Open the mouth, sigh it out. That's right, hold, deep breath in. Hold the breath. Take another sip of air in and just hold. Relax the shoulders and the jaw. Open your mouth, sigh it out, let it go. Deep breath in. Hold the breath. One more sip air in. Hold, relax the shoulders and the jaw. Open your mouth, sigh it out. Let it all go as the mind distracts. Again, just become aware of it and simply hold that. Repeat your mantra, your intention. You're just with us. Doesn't it feel good to forgive yourself? You don't have to be afraid or reluctant to do that anymore. Forgiving yourself doesn't mean you're condemned. It means you're setting yourself free. We can gather so much guilt as we go through life. We may blame ourselves for the experiences we've had,
or how we've handled them. We may build up resentments against ourselves. We may even resist forgiving ourselves because we think that means saying that we are bad or wrong. But not forgiving ourselves when we need to often leads us to return to the situations that are unhealthy for us. Forgiving yourself means you can leave places that feel bad. You can end relationships that no longer work. You can avoid situations that cause you continual pain and grief. Forgiving yourself means you can't stop punishing yourself for what you've done. You can stop punishing yourself for what you've done and what you think you've done wrong. You don't have to hold your mistakes against yourself. You don't have to deprive yourself of comfort, joy, love, and acceptance. It's much easier to say, I made a mistake. This isn't right for me. I don't like this. This is wrong, than to forgive yourself. Forgive yourself if you've done something wrong. Forgive yourself even if you haven't done something wrong. Then see how good forgiveness feels. Forgive yourself and be free. So thank you, yogis, yoginis, for practicing this morning, allowing me to guide you both in studio and at home. Truly, truly so grateful for all of the support. Take a moment to thank our teachers and their teachers for bringing us this practice in a much, much needed time. And as always, thank yourself. Say thank you, self, for showing up today for you. The divine in me, it honors, it cherishes the divine and mostly the light inside of each and every one of you. Namaste.